not the smoothest performance, but a battling performance that got three important points.
Yeah, I think obviously we're never going to get it our own way every game. I think today we're playing against a very, very good Widnes side. No teams have come here and let us have it all our own way. So again, I thought the boys were professional, they did the job, and again, I thought they were very, very good and very clear for the 3 points today.
Fitness-wise, though, they stood up well and with the fitness side in the end.
Yeah, we have. I've said it before, the lads are fit, they're strong, they're in great shape at the moment. Again, I've been lucky when I came here that I was able to bring Lee Fernand with me, so he knows what he's doing. He's one of the best fitness coaches I've worked with, and to get to be able to have him here with me, obviously makes my job a lot easier.
Opportunity scored by the skipper, Brad Carroll, first half. The two players left it to each other, and Brad nipped in and scored.
Yeah, I said that to Brad before, that he needs to start making gambles into the box and something will break for him. Again, I think today, Brad Carroll was fantastic there. That was the Brad Carroll that I know we've got in that dressing room. I think he's just, fortunately, he's had a bit of time away in pre-season with his injury and things like that, but he's starting to catch up now, and I think today really showed it. And again, with Tinners being out, I needed someone to step up and lead the team, and I thought Brad Carroll was fantastic today.
You got Connor on for late in the game, and he provided the corner which got the second. How did you see that goal? Was that an own goal?
And that's Connor Tinners' goal, and keep it out. So for me, it's Tinners' goal. I think Nate's trying to claim it, but that's a striker for you. So again, I thought we were just starting to get a little bit overrun in the middle.
Hey, Dad.
I thought that if we get Tinners on, he'd get hold of the ball, as he always does. Again, thought they'd have control of the game and settle us down for a big 10 minutes
problem. No serious injuries as far as
you
can see at the moment?
No, nothing at the moment, so we'll assess tomorrow and Monday, and then we'll go down to Cunningham on Tuesday, hoping we're fully fit squad.
Yeah, that's what we want, and just to follow up against a Clitheroe side that started, I think they're in and out, aren't they? One of those sides that are producing in and out for moments.
Yeah, I think again, Clitheroe are a good team when they get going, and we need to make sure that we're all game to get points on the road. As we keep changing the lads, as long as we keep winning the road, picking up points on the road will be
good. Yeah, you must be pleased at that, the way your career in management started at this stage. I know it's early days, but sitting top of the league, you can't argue with that.
It's what the boys are doing. The boys are putting in the performances that warrant those to get results. And I think, as I said to them in there, now, I haven't got enough praise for them at the moment. I've honestly run out of praise for them. They've been so good since I came in. The attitude, the work rate, everything like that. Like I said to them in there, they're good players as well. And they are showing that out there. And yeah, I think if we can just keep building and chipping away, as we can build some special this season.
Yeah, aware of your squad. Do you have rotation as your... That's one of the things you believe in, rotating your squad?
I think it's hard, obviously. It's great when you can run with 11 fit players and you know that you're going to get the same out of them every week. But I think the way we play, the intensity that we play at, I think it's hard to expect lads to be able to do it week in, week out, every 2 or 3 days. So we need to make sure that we're fresh. We need to make sure that we can get on the pitch and put pressure on the teams. Because, as I said to them now, we've nicked the ball back off in really dangerous areas there. And again, I thought the lads were clinical with the chances. And on another day, put another 2 or 3.
Danny, well done. Thanks very much.